What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Today's going to be a little bit different kind of a video. I actually have to catch a plane in about 4 hours to fly home, but I want to get a video up on the channel. It's been about 2 weeks since I posted anything. So, yeah, I get a lot of questions asking how we're going to make a 800 horsepower STI. Obviously, I haven't started the build yet for the most part, but I just want to take a second to kind of explain everything that's going into it, what I plan on putting into the car to produce that kind of power. So I guess we'll probably start with the power plant itself. So if you watched any of my previous videos, you'd see that I have a EJ257 that's closed decked, all the machine work's done by Outfront, half inch head studs, all that's all milled out. So inside the block, we're going to be doing manly turbo tough pistons with the little bit thicker of a wrist pin, and then we're going to do the manly H tough rods, which is essentially an H beam but thicker. It's like a bigger rod than your typical H beam, a little bit stronger. And then along with that, I'm just going to be doing like a modified OEM crankshaft. Don't really need anything bigger than that. They make like billet crankshafts, but I don't think you're going to need it for 800. I think I've seen people run 1,000 plus on OEM crankshafts, so we should be good there. All the bearings in the block are all going to be ACL, so number 5 thrust, 52 millimeter rod bearings, those are all going to be ACL. Pretty sure that kind of finishes off the short block, I think. It's everything, crankshaft, rods, pistons, bearings. Yeah, I think that's it. So head gaskets, moving on to head gaskets. I have the JE Pro Seals, but I'm kind of in between doing those and the Athena fire ring gaskets. I think I might switch to the fire ring just so I don't have to, if I end up blowing these head gaskets, it'll just save me from having to dive back in and do it again. So I think I might go straight to the Athenas. Let's see. So the head studs are ARP 2000s. They should be plenty enough to handle the power goals we're going for. Now moving on to the head, I do have to get my heads machined. I'll take it to a local machine shop, get those done. So in the head, we're probably gonna be doing BC 280 cams. I think I can probably run stock valves. I'd still gotta do a little bit more research on that since this is my first high horsepower Subaru build. Yeah, definitely gotta figure out valves. We'll set valve lash, do all that ourselves. And yeah, that's pretty much it for in the block, I think. Obviously we'll order everything new, but yeah, I think that's it. As far as ABCS goes, I think I'm just gonna keep the stock cam gears on there for now, just because I know some tuners don't like to tune with non-ABCS or ABCS deleted cam gears. Yeah, it's kind of just preference, but I think for now I'm just gonna keep the stock cam gears on. I know a few buddies that are running 1,000 horsepower on those, so we should be good there. Let's see, what else we got? So moving on towards the back of the block, clutch, we're gonna be running a Exetti triple disc clutch. That'll be, once again, plenty enough for the power goals we're going for. Underneath the block, we're gonna be doing either a Killer B or an IAG oil pan and pickup baffle setup. I'll definitely stick with one of those two. I know really good things about those. So moving on to the top of the block, I think I'm gonna do a Process West intake manifold. I know those accommodate really well if you have a rotated setup, and they provide really, really good airflow. So I'm gonna stick with that. Probably stick with stock throttle body, run an Omni 4-bar. Might have to move to a 5-bar in the future, but 4-bar should be good for now. So that kind of covers the top. Turbo kit, we're gonna be doing an ETS rotated kit. I was kind of in between a 6870 and a 6466, but talking to some people, I think we'll be able to easily hit the 800 horsepower power goals with a 6466 wide opened up on like 45 pounds. So I'll probably stick with that. The 6870 is really good, but it's drivability, since I still want the car to be somewhat of a daily driver. I know a 6870 takes a longer time to spool. and the drivability just isn't as good as the 6466. So that's why I kind of decided to stick on the 64 side. So within that ETS kit, that kind of comes with the turbo, the downpipe. I'm gonna do their new like V2 manifold, up pipe, all that kind of stuff comes with the kit. Front mount intercooler, we're gonna be doing either a 4 or 5 inch ETS intercooler. I already have all the piping. Actually, on Marketplace popped up, there was titanium ETS piping. It came up for a super sick deal, so scoop that up. So we have that. The intake itself with the filter is also from ETS. That comes with the rotated kit, so we're covered there. Let's see. All right, moving on. Let's talk a little bit about a fuel system. So fuel system is kind of something that I wasn't thinking much of when I kind of came up with this and never realized how much money might go into it. But this is what I'm thinking. We run a radium dual fuel pump hanger in the tank with two Walbro 450s that should supply plenty enough fuel. From there, we'll run AN lines all the way to the front of the car to probably an aeromotive fuel pressure regulator. We got to run a Cobb flex fuel kit so we can run either E85 or pump gas. And then from there, I think I'm just going to order up an IAG kit from their website. And that'll include all the lines that you have to run through the fuel rails. It'll include the fuel rails. And I think for injectors, either I'll get the 2600s with the kit, or I'll do like an ID2000 that I don't think they have on IAG's website, but I'll have to buy them separately because I don't think, I don't know if they don't make them anymore. It's just harder to find, but yeah, either 2600s or ID2000s be plenty. That's a lot. So that'll cover fuel. We talked about air. We talked about, yeah, the turbo kit, the block itself, clutch. I'll probably order up one of those coil radiators. Replace the stock one with that. Maybe order up one of those like front-mounted oil coolers that they make. Yeah, I think Perrin makes one and Mishimoto also makes one. I might order up one of those. Those are kind of optional, I believe. Obviously, we already have the access port in the car. You're gonna need that. I'm running TGV deletes from, I think they're IAG TGV deletes. They're already in the car. Put them in a previous video. So those will sit underneath the manifold. I already have the IAG AOS in the car. That's definitely recommended. So I've heard that with the AOS, the competition series that you have to run on these cars, the breather tube that sits on top, once you start running like 40 plus pounds of boost, they actually start dumping a lot of oil. And being that the breather tube kind of runs out the back of the car, you really don't want that getting under your tires as you're doing a pull. I know Ranch Built, who's a local like fabrication shop here over by Spokane, they actually made a catch can that goes directly from that breather tube on the AOS and it feeds into the catch can instead of running underneath the car. So I'll probably do something like that just to be safe. And that'll sit over kind of where the stock intercooler is on the car right now. I think we kind of covered just about everything. Blow off valve, it's probably just gonna be a teal tile, however you wanna call it. Blow-off valve, wastegate will be a precision one. I think that's what comes in the kit. For the crank pulley, or the harmonic balancer, whatever you want to call it, we're going to do like the ATI super dampener. Those things work extremely well. The car will be converted to speed density, so no more mass airflow. And then lastly, just little things like motor mounts. Probably do like a Torque Solutions motor mount setup, something like that. And that kind of concludes it all, really. Obviously all the gaskets and O-rings will be replaced, whether it's valve cover gaskets or like little oil pickup O-rings, anything like that will all be replaced. It'll be built right. So for those wondering how we're going to make that power, that's pretty much how we're going to do it. And then as far as tuning the car, because I am in Spokane, kind of lucky enough to have Josh Bader right down the road. So I'll hit him up, see if we can get the car in the dyno when it's all done. And that'll really be it. So if you guys are wanting to do one of these builds yourself and you're kind of wondering how much it costs, I haven't really added it all up, but I mean, expect to spend, unless you have like sponsorships, it's probably gonna be upwards of 25K plus if you do it yourself. I think Bader, if you were gonna have like Bader do the whole build for you for like a 6466 build, I think he charges up north of 35K for it. But yeah, if you do it yourself, obviously you can save a few bucks. Yeah, I mean, it's expensive, but at the same time, you know, what do you expect if you're building a car with that much horsepower? It takes a lot of time, it takes a lot of money. So everyone that wants to build these cars, I just tell them, you know, save up and you do one step at a time. You don't have to go crazy and do it all at once. It's a process. I mean, I've had this car a little over a year now and we're just starting the engine build. So it takes time, but I'm super stoked that I get to do this, have the time to put it on YouTube. It's actually really cool to go back and see kind of everything that we've done. So yeah, super stoked. Hope you guys are enjoying it. That's probably gonna wrap up this video. I have to go make this flight, but I'll catch you guys in the next one. Once I get back home, I think the next thing we gotta do, we gotta wrap the roof on the STI. I have everything to do that, but last night we got a lot of snow and it's been cold. And if you know anything about vinyl wrap, it's not fun to put on in the cold, if even virtually possible. So I gotta do control arms on the Duramax. We got a few Duramax things to do. And then we're kind of just moving on from there. So I hope this video helped you if you're trying to do like kind of the same build. That was kind of the goal of it. I think I'm kind of overbuilding a little bit. Like, for example, I think you could still run in a stock intake manifold and make the same power. But, yeah, I just, you know, I'd rather have more than less. And that way we can always shoot for more without having to buy a whole bunch of extra stuff. So if you have any questions, feel free to drop a comment down below or hit me up on Instagram at @bshownborn. And I'll be happy to help. Until then, I'll catch you in the next video. Peace out. See y'all later.